Hello and welcome to News Review once again. As you can see, we're not in our normal studio. We are working from home because of the coronavirus outbreak, like many millions of other people. But Catherine is with me, virtually, on the other side of London. Hi, Catherine.
Hello, Neil. Hello, everybody. Yes, working from home again, but we're still here. We're still bringing you News Review. And today's story is about a massive choir that's happening in people's living rooms all over the UK.
Let's hear some more about that story then from this BBC News Bulletin.
BBC radio stations have joined forces for a national sing-along. To lift the spirits of people staying at home, songs requested by listeners are being played. Radio 1's Greg James got the party started with Florence and the Machines' You've Got the Love.
Yes, so the people of Britain have started singing to help them cope with staying at home during the coronavirus lockdown. Now, this was an idea by 5 BBC radio stations. They all played listeners' requests at the same time. The people of Britain started singing along with the music, and they posted and filmed clips of themselves singing onto social media.
Okay, well, you've been looking at this story across the media and you've picked out 3 headlines that have got interesting vocabulary. What are they?
Yes, we have sing-along, airs and praises.
Sing-along, airs and praises. Okay, let's hear your first headline, please, then, Catherine.
Okay, so all our headlines are coming from the UK today. The first one is from the BBC. BBC radio stars lead the nation in a mass sing-along.
Sing-along, an informal occasion when people sing songs together. Simple enough?
Simple enough, yes. It's one word, sing-along, made of 2 words, sing-along. S-I-N-G-A-L-O-N-G. Nice word, Neil, isn't it? Sing-along.
It is, and you pointed out that when we use it as a verb, it's 2 words. Sing along. The stress is
That's
different.
Right.
The stress is different when it's one word. Sing along.
Absolutely, yes. You can sing along with something as a verb, but as a noun, it's a sing along, and it means people singing together. Now, a sing along is not formal, it's very informal, it's very relaxed. It sometimes happens spontaneously when you're with some friends and everybody starts singing a song. Either because they all know it, or because somebody's playing it, or maybe you're at a party and someone gets the guitar out and people start singing together. So this is very, very informal. It's for fun. People like doing it. And it's called a sing-along. Do you like sing-alongs, Neil?
I love a sing-along.
What's your favourite song to sing along to?
Oh, I've got some karaoke favourites. But I was in a pub a few weeks ago before this lockdown, and a very old-fashioned thing happened. A guy was playing a piano and people were having a good old sing-along.
Ah, lovely, isn't it? Everybody, all different ages, all singing a song in a pub, old-fashioned. Those were the days.
And you noticed I said a good old.
You did. A good old sing-along is a lovely expression, and it just means really enjoyable and without any fancy or different ways of doing something. Just simple, classic and enjoyable. A good old sing-along. So do you fancy a good old sing-along now, Neil?
Why not?
Come on then. Tell you what, I'll start the tune and you see, you join it when you know what it is. Okay?
Okay. Yeah.
All right, here we go.
That's the BBC Learning English theme.
A classic. Well, I feel a lot better now.
We also say a sing-song for the same thing, don't we?
Yes, a sing-song is another noun and it's another word for a sing-along. If you have a sing-song, it means a lot of people or a few people get together informally and they sing some popular songs. So you can have a sing-along, you can join a sing-along, you can have a sing-song or join a sing-song, you can join in with a sing-along, or you can join in with a good old sing-song.
And I think the whole world should have a go at doing that to cheer themselves up.
Yeah, always makes you feel good.
Okay, let's have a summary. Okay, Catherine, how about your second headline, please?
Okay, we will go to Largs Millport News now. The headline is Great British Sing-Along airs across 5 BBC stations.
Airs, meaning broadcasts.
Nice short word, A-I-R-S, airs. Now it's a verb, to air, and it means broadcast, as in to make a TV programme or a radio programme available for public consumption. Now, let me ask you a question, Neil. When you turn on your radio and you listen to the radio, where does the sound come from?
Ah, well, there is a signal which is broadcast, and that signal travels through the air to my radio.
It travels through the air. You can't see it, you can't feel it, but it's travelling through the air. And then there's a piece of metal on your radio that sticks up and catches the signal, doesn't it?
Yeah, an aerial.
Aerial. So to air a programme, A-I-R, means to send it through the air so that people can catch it with their aerial on their radio or TV and listen to it. Now, not everybody's TV has an aerial these days. A lot of people have cable, but the word to air, it means to broadcast a TV or radio programme.
It does. And it's a little bit formal, a little bit old-fashioned, let's say. You're more likely to say something is just on. You're less likely to say, Catherine, I love watching football. It always airs at 10:30 on a Saturday night.
Yeah, that sounds a bit weird, doesn't it?
Yeah.
You just say, the football's on at 9 o'clock this evening. But newspaper headlines like it because it's nice and short. And lots of publishers seem to like it. Also, in radio or TV studios, if you ever go to one, you will see a green light and a red light outside the studio, usually green and red. If the red light is on, it will usually say on air. And on air means they're broadcasting right now. They are sending out that signal or recording.
We also hear this word used in connection with opinions or points of view, don't we?
We do, yes. If you air your opinion, you tell people what you think. Now, again, it's not particularly formal, but there's a particular type of opinion that you might like to air, and it's generally a fairly negative opinion. I don't air my opinion about things I'm happy about. I just give my opinion. But if I'm airing my opinion about the lack of biscuits in the office, although that's not a problem now, I would be complaining about something.
I've heard you airing your opinions about Rob's biscuit habits.
I have, and he's heard me airing them too.
Okay, well, there's no problem with stealing biscuits in the office at the moment, but he can eat at home to his heart's content.
Shall we have a summary?
Let's have a summary slide. If you like stories about singing and music, we have a great one for you. It's about bands touring and their attempts to reduce their carbon footprint, their impact on the environment. Where can they find it, Catherine?
Easy. Just click the link in the description. You'll go straight to the show.
Okay, so our final headline now. Have you got that there with you?
I have. Now we're looking at the Evening Standard. The headline is Greg James praises power of radio as listeners come together for BBC's Great British Sing-Along.
Praises, meaning expresses admiration for someone or something.
That's right. And it's a verb, P-R-A-I-S-E-S, praises. Now, the pronunciation's really interesting because it's spelt with two S letters, but the pronunciation, they are Z sounds, praises. Do as a demonstration, Neil, please.
Praises.
praises. Thank you very much. Now, if you praise something, you say that it is great, it's fantastic, it's wonderful. And you do this in particular in public. Praise is saying publicly that something's good often. You can also praise a person, you can praise somebody. It doesn't have to be for a big achievement. You can praise your kids for tidying their bedrooms, for example. Just say, well done, that was really good, you did it very well. That's praise.
It is. Now, you've been using it as a verb, except for in that last example, you used it as a noun. Can you tell us more about that?
Well spotted, yeah. So praise is the noun form. You can give praise, you can receive praise. And praise is a noun of praises. So praise is the nice things that you say to somebody or the nice things you say about something when it's something really good has happened.
Now, there are a couple of nice little expressions using this word. One connected to today's story about singing, to sing someone's praises.
You can sing somebody's praises. That means if you say that somebody is really good and fantastic and you like them and you think they're wonderful, and especially if you do it a lot, you're singing their praises. Yeah, it's a really nice expression that we use when somebody really likes somebody and is very vocal about it. Yeah.
And you can also use the expression to be full of praise.
Same meaning. If you're full of praise for somebody, or full of praise for something, it means you've got lots of positive things to say about them. And I'll give you one more, and that is you can praise somebody or something to the skies. If you praise someone to the skies, you say lots of fantastic, wonderful things about them.
Absolutely. Okay, well, let's have a summary of that word. Right then, Catherine, now time just for a vocab recap, please.
Here we go. We had sing-along, an informal occasion where people sing songs together. We had airs, which means broadcasts. And finally, praises, expresses admiration for someone or something.
If you would like to test yourself on this vocabulary, there's a quiz on our website, bbclearningenglish.com. You can find all kinds of other videos and activities to help you improve your English. Goodbye, everybody, and stay safe.
Bye. Stay safe, everyone.